Petrovil in second place continues to stalk him, and then comes We Ride the World. On the left is Scaletti, the maroon jacket is too far at the back of the field. Persian King asks for maximum effort now and has not shaken these off. In fact, they're about to swamp him. Petrovil in the white, Scaletti up on the outside, Persian King against the running rail, having a real fight on its hands now. We Ride behind those. Persian King is pulling out a little bit more, playing with them in the end. Wasn't quite as nice as you would have seen for a long odds on favourite, but he has delivered.
Stormy Antarctic on the outside, in third placing then was Pogo, followed by Century Dream, and next in the field then is Motomaris. It's Persian King. Persian King has taken the lead. He's starting to draw clear in the dying stages. The favourite's too good. He's very good, Persian King. Persian King wins again. Stormy
comes Romanized and the white cap of Victor Ladorum still at the rear of the field. They head down with 400 meters to go. Persian King on the left coming to get Circus Maximus. There's still three lengths behind. A Sisk in the pink cap in third. Running on well, Victor Ladorum. Pina Tubo next, but Persian King is clear. 200 meters to go. Pina Tubo's going to try and run him down, and he's gaining very fast in the closing stages, but Persian King has won.
And Bangkok, Pondus, Pablo Escobar, Private Secretary, Japan, down the outside, Jack Yates has wilted, Bangkok and Private Secretary, Pablo Escobar, and Japan is continuing to run home strongly on the outside, and Japan has swept past Bangkok and Private Secretary, and then Pablo Escobar, it's the Derby third, Japan, in the hands of Ryan Moore, clear of Bangkok, Eagles by day staying on well, but it's Japan a class apart in the King Edward VII, Japan wins. Second home will be Bangkok in third place, Eagles by day.
And also on the outside, Japan. Japan has moved up and takes the lead into the clear. Slalom runs on. They were followed by Roman Candle. It's Japan taking the lead inside the final 200. Here's Roman Candle and Slalom trying hard in second and third placings. But it is Japan in front, getting close to the line. And Japan wins. Japan has won the Grand Prix de Paris. Slalom, a great run into second place.
Having a decent battle. A length and a half to two away then to King of Comedy. Regal Reality is next. Cheval Grand is under pressure. Lord Glitters and Thundering Blue with quite a bit on as they race on down towards the final two furlongs here. Crystal Ocean now is being produced to take over. Crystal Ocean is the meat in the O'Brien sandwich at the moment. On the inside, weakening Circus Maximus. Japan on the outside. Crystal Ocean digging deep as he always does. King of Comedy, Regal Reality trying to mount a challenge as well. Crystal Ocean just wilting out in front as Japan comes back to him. Japan and Crystal Ocean. Crystal Ocean responds on the inside, Japan on the outside, it's a tight one. Japan may have just got there from Crystal Ocean. LR Khan back in third, and in fourth, King of Comedy.
They're both going at it a long way from home, coming around the turn. Dave on the inside, a Very Elegant goes stride for stride, and Very Elegant really pouring the pressure on now. Very Elegant, the outside of a Dave. She gets about a neck in front, but a Dave comes back on the inside, three lengths clear from Avelius. It's Very Elegant, and a Dave, shades of the earlier race. A Dave's lifting on the inside. A Very Elegant, a Dave, and Very Elegant, a Dave strong, and a Dave goes on to win the Randvert. What a super ride by Tom Marquin, one and a half length to Very Elegant, a big gap back to Avelius. Then main runners, Tiao Cow Shark, Melody Bell is slicing through. Master of Wines getting onto the back of the Japanese horse as they turn, and a Dave makes the move now at the 400 metres, and a Dave draws clear, but here's Dannon Premium. Wow, look at him come into a Dannon Premium. He moves up now to a Dave. This is what we've been waiting for. A Dave, the inside of Dannon Premium. Very Elegant goes to third, but a Dave's full of running at the 100 metres. In fact, he's ripping clear now. And a big win for a Dave in the Queen Elizabeth Stakes. Very Elegant got through for second in front of Dannon Premium.
Dave has been ridden along, now drops back to fourth. Here comes San Donato moving up on the outside with a big looking effort inside the final quarter mile. Fox Sherman narrowly from Yukon Glen and San Donato. A Dave is trying to get rolling now between horses. Then came Lord Glitters and What's the Story in Dalgano. They race now to the final furlong, and a Dave has found something for pressure all right. He's burst through now to lead inside the last. Lord Glitters with a late surge down the outside. It's a Dave from Lord Glitters, and a Dave is going to win the Doonside Cup. A Dave is the winner from Lord Glitters, with San Donato in third. Then came
Cayenne Pepper in the red cap, followed off the bend by True Self and Fleeting. Racing in the straight with 2.5 furlongs to go. And Magical is pointing the toe out for home, has readily gone clear from Rocco Roma. And then Cayenne Pepper, True Self and Fleeting in the center of the track. But Magical is in glorious isolation, racing to the final furlong. Is way out in front of Cayenne Pepper. Fleeting is running on the outside of True Self. But it's multiple Group 1 winner Magical, who's set to add another on her return to action. The Alwa's Mere Pretty Polly Stakes, a brilliant return. Cayenne Pepper second, third Fleeting, fourth True Self. Rocking comes Sir Dragonet, and these have left Search for a Song. Passing the two, and it's Magical, the leader from Leo de Fury. Buckhurst is on the rail, and then Sir Dragonet, who's angled out ahead of Armory in Search for a Song, but it's Magical. Magical by 3 lengths, racing just outside the final furlong, and it's Magical opening up a clear lead over a running on Sir Dragonet, and then comes Leo de Fury, but racing into the last half furlong, it's Magical out on her own in many ways. And will defend her title in the Group 1 Tattersall's Gold Cup. Second Sir Dragonet, third Search for a Song. Matching strides on the turn into the straight. Then comes Japan, Sotsas Armory. 4 lengths to Lear the Fury into the straight. 2 furlongs to go. And it's Gayath from Magical. And Japan's gone for the rail. Sotsas Armory stays on. Racing towards the final furlong and a half. Roll up, roll up. It's Magical on the near side. Who's trying to exact revenge on Gayath. Armory is on the outside with Sotsas. It's Magical for her second Irish champion stakes. Lowers the colours of Gayath. Armory, Sotsas, Japan.
What is behind those? Heading down to the two marker. On the right, Mohatha delivering a challenge with a noseband is Hello Yume Zane. Boitre on the light blue, and nearest to us is Urban Icon, the black sleeves. Great Scott is running on as well. At the furlong pole, though, Mohatha has gone through to a length and a half lead. Great Scott and Urban Icon are chasing him down as they race towards the line. Mohatha and Jim Crowley, but a length ahead, and they're going to win. Mohatha's won. Great Scott in second place. Urban Icon in third. Very
last month, now shaken up by Joe Fanning. Lord Tennyson poised to strike first. Skardu beat Le Bon, going for the inside. Duke of Hazard, Urban Icon running a big race. Then Zaki Mahatha is towards the right. Dane O'Neill's just nursing this horse closer now. He looks fairly confident. It's Urban Icon, Duke of Hazard, about to be picked up by Mahatha. San Donato running a blinder on his comeback, but Mahatha has got to the front, running towards the last half furlong, and it's Mahatha chased all the way by Duke of Hazard. San Donato, Lord Glitter's plugging on, but Mahatha was different gear and won the summer mile. Second, San Donato, Duke of Hazard, that's close. Then Lord Glitters.
At the rear of the field, they've got to the two marker. San Donato runs a massive race at a big price here. Siskin is trailing him through on the outside. Circus Maximus, Kamiko is looking for room as well. Still there is Witchard as they head down to the closing stages. Circus Maximus is very brave. Siskin and Mohatha in the blue and white coming down the outside to challenge. Mohatha in the blue and white comes late on to grab victory in the Qatar Sussex. Circus Maximus in second, then Siskin, Kamiko, Wichita behind those Sandon.
Liam Canary, the gap isn't there at the moment for Indeed, and now Lord North is the one that quickens up best. Lord North has quickly gone to the front here, edging across to the rail ahead of Pablo Escobar. Now Indeed into the clear, followed by Aquarium, Air Pilot not today. Lord North struck the front some way out. Indeed and Pablo Escobar are harrying him all the way up the hill, but Lord North with the stands rail to guide him home is going to win again at Newmarket, the Cambridgeshire winner as the James Seymour Stakes. Tight set.
Just angles for a position coming to attack. Ella Cam in the centre, who's shaken up inside the two. Lord North now nosing on from Ella Cam. Sangarius on the near side from King Otica. Telecaster makes his effort on the far side. Lord North, though, quickened up well with a furlong and a half to go, has dashed on down inside the last furlong with a lead of 2 lengths. Ella Cam, though, rallying bravely on the near side. Telecaster is boxing on. Lord North with a 100 yards to go. Ella Cam sticking to the task. Lord North all out. Ella Cam with a thrust. Lord North just clinging on in the Brigadier Gerard from the round.
Trying to make progress as well. Two furlongs to go, and Bangkok continues to be in front. Adabe in second place. Mehdi has moved into third. Japan is next. Then Headman on the extreme right. And at the furlong pole, the seven runners will virtually be in line here. Adabe just leading to Lord North in the blue and white now. He's shot through from the back of the field with James Doyle. Surges through to the lead. And it's Lord North who now begins to clear away another superstar here. Lord North wins by three or four lengths. Adabe in second, third, might have gone to Barney Roy. Bangkok and Japan maybe in a
free. Here comes Kinross as well, looking for its way through. Verbota now ridden for more as they go towards the final furlong and a half. It's Kamiko who's out in front now. Kamiko leading from Innisfree in second, then the Era of the Tiger and Mogul, followed then by Kinross. He's under pressure inside the final furlong. It's Kamiko under Ashin Murphy by about 2 to 3 lengths now inside the final half. It's Kamiko clear from Mogul, Year of the Tiger and Innisfree, and up to the line. It's Kamiko to win the Virtue and Futurity Trophy. Pretty tight second, Innisfree together with Mogul.
Leaders as they head down to the two marker. Wan Alkano in yellow against the running well, battling on well. Wichita between those is Pina Tubo. Kamiko coming down the centre of the course. Military March is in behind that. They head down into the dip now. Pina Tubo trying to see off Wichita. Kamiko behind those. And then Military March as they head into the closing stages. And it's Wichita at the moment in the purple cap. Kamiko the far side of him going through to lead late on. Kamiko's one to Wichita, second Pina Tubo. Military March
out in front, but Top Rank challenging hard. Kamiko picking up now in the claret colours, coming through, followed by Tilsit, and then back to Regal Reality. And Kamiko has come through to Head Ben Battle, running into the dip. It's Kamiko from Ben Battle, as now they race uphill inside the final furlong. Kamiko just in front, Ben Battle. Regal Reality is finishing well. Kamiko needs the line. Regal Reality is thrusting. Kamiko returns to the scene of his great win in the Guineas and wins again. From Regal Reality.
Dante's enjoying himself in front. He races down towards the final three furlongs, but Stradivarius now moves through the gears and he goes up now into second place. Look at the way Frankie's sitting on board the champion. Cleante's flat out now for Ashin Murphy, and now for the first time Frankie's just asking Stradivarius just to close that gap. He's got it down to about a length now on the inside. Max Dynamite's running a big one. Just a furlong to go here in the Doncaster Cup of 2019, and Stradivarius is produced on the outside to strike the front for the first time. And there he goes, the outstanding, the brilliant champion Stradivarius adds the Doncaster Cup to his illustrious CV. He lands the odds from Cleante in third place.
Around there, he's looking pretty confident as they swing the corner, and now pulling wide Stradivarius, chased by Mekong and then Technician, and Prince of Aaron struggling, and Cross Counter, and out in front Naif Row. But here comes Stradivarius, absolutely cruising along, breezing along on the bridle. In third place, Moonlight Spirit. In fourth, then is Withhold from Cross Counter, and now Frankie says go on Stradivarius, and it's an immediate response, and he quickens right away from Naif Road. 6 lengths, 8 lengths, he's going to be 10 lengths, he's going to absolutely streak them. The best stayer in the world, Stradivarius, 3 gold cups clear of Naif Road in third, Cross Counter, and with
a 2.5 length lead over Santiago in second. The first move is on the right from Spanish Mission. Pink Jacket James Dawes sends him through. Stradivarius is sitting on the tail of Santiago at the moment. They're about third and fourth. In behind those, Eagles by Day. They head down towards the last quarter mile. Still in front is Neyev Road. Santiago's come out after him. Eagles by Day has moved into third. Stradivarius is only fourth short of Vroom. Then comes Spanish Mission as they head down now towards the last furlong. Santiago's moved through on the outside of Neyev Road. Now Stradivarius is in full stretch down the centre of the black and yellow. 100 yards from the line. Stradivarius produced late by Frankie. What a stare this horse is. Stradivarius creates history, looked in trouble, but that was a fourth Alstra Cab Goodwood Cup for him. Neyev Road and Santiago second. And
also beginning to make a move. They head down inside the final quarter of a mile, and Acquitted now has taken over from a tiring Minoski. Palace Pier is off after Acquitted, but has got a couple of lengths to find and needs to find them quickly. A furlong left to travel here. Acquitted not stopping. Palace Pier over to the far side is gradually edging a little bit closer though, and now Palace Pier gets on top. Palace Pier forges away by a couple of lengths in the closing stages, and Palace Pier remains unbeaten. Palace Pier beating Acquitted into second. There was daylight between them at the end. Close up in behind them, Yoshimi, and over to the far side, he's a keeper.
And in behind, runners still in that all-blue jacket is William Buick on Pinatubo. He's now just angled out for a run down the home straight. Wichita taken on by Threat, who comes there strongly. But look at Pinatubo and Palace Pier. These two are galloping into contention now as they stretch on towards the final furlong. Wichita has ridden hard. Pinatubo challenging. Palace Pier on the outside. It's just Pinatubo. Palace Pier, though, is still attacking. Wichita is rallying on the far side. A three-way go in the St. James's Palace. And Palace Pier is getting up in the last few strides. And Palace Pier wins. Ran down Wichita and Pinatubo.
Sides now. Here on the near side goes Alpine Star. Palace Pier is coming through. And Palace Pier and Alpine Star now go on. And it's Palace Pier from Alpine Star. They've left the rest behind. Palace Pier and Frankie Dettori goes a couple of lengths clear, handling the ground really well. And it's Palace Pier is going to be five from five, a second group one. And Palace Pier makes the trip worthwhile for Dettori. Palace Pier's won it from Alpine Star in second. And these two way clear of Circus Mac.
Pick up as now they race inside the final two furlongs. Still Gaiath the leader. Stradivarius about four lengths down in second. Anthony Van Dyke continues to run on well down the outside. They're going to run uphill inside the final furlong. Gaiath is keeping up the gallop. Anthony Van Dyke still with four lengths to find as they race now with 100 left to go. And Gaiath, a fantastic performance from the front. Gaiath wins the Coronation Cup in tremendous style. Anthony
out clear by three. In second, Japan is now being ridden along, and now Enable is urged to try and close by Frankie Dettori, and she's willingly picking them up now. She's got to within three lengths of Gaiath. Japan now in second. Enable is in third. Magic One from a long way back takes fourth. The racing now inside the final full and a half. Gaiath is digging in. He leads by three parts of a length. Japan there in the centre, and on the outside is Enable. There's a half furlong to go. Gaiath has the rail to help. He still leads by a length and a half. Enable is running out of time, and it's Gaiath who's going to take the Coral Eclipse. Gaiath has won the Eclipse. Tight second between Enable and Japan, followed in fourth by Magic One.
On the bridle to try and challenge here. Up the inside then is Kamiko. Gaiath still the lead, but it's just being whittled back a little bit now as the others try to close on the inside. What has Will Buick got left? Now he gets to work on Gaiath as Kamiko moves up into second place on the inside. Magical next then with Lord North and Rose of Kildare. Gaiath passes the furlong marker, still too clear. Magical battling as ever in second place, but Gaiath has not seen another rival, and he's going to see them all off here in the Jumbot. He's relentless. Gaiath completes a great group one hat-trick and wins the Jumbot from Magical.
In blue and white colours, Jim Crowley on Batash has the advantage, now leads by over a length. Tis Marvellous and Liberty Beach in second and third places to the right. Equilateral starting to stay on. Then over the far side is Glass Slippers, but they're inside the final furlong. It's Batash, two or three lengths clear. It's going to be third time lucky for him. Batash is going to win the King's Stand. He won it very impressively indeed. Liberty Beach and Equilateral very tight between those second and third. Tis Marvellous was next and a few lengths behind
Batash. He's got about two lengths in hand on Glass Slippers. Ornate is fading away and racing inside the final furlong. Batash, Glass Slippers still trying very hard in second place, but Batash is pulling away, and up towards the line is a fourth King George Cattle Stakes for the fastest horse in Britain. Batash from Glass Slippers and running on well. Ornate kept
Batash, then Curious in a maroon jacket, Mosgill in the pale silks held together, Ayali in the beige jacket ridden along. The grey Art Power is under pressure, getting reminders they've gone past halfway. Further back, Ornate second from the right, extreme right, Emiratiana. Heading on down now towards the last furlong and a half, and it's Batash in the centre now, moving through to challenge Keamoro. Mosgill is out in pursuit of the leading pair. Inside the furlong they come. Batash is having to work hard to wear down Keamoro. Mosgill back in third. Batash pokes his nose ahead. Keamoro fighting on grimly. Batash, though, doing best. Crowley again, a fabulous four-time. And it's back-to-back wins and the non-thought for Batash from Keamoro. It was close for third between